This is a Fox 17 winter weather alert.
And that is a live look over downtown Grand Rapids, where we've picked up about a foot of snow so far today. Now the cold air is moving in, and it's going to be brutal. Something you won't hear us say here too often at Fox 17, but brutal sums it up.
Yeah, our team coverage continues tonight. Fox 17's Anne-Marie LaFlame is live to show us some of the complications of clearing the snow in this Arctic cold and blowing snow. Kevin Craig is tracking the record-setting cold that's moving in tonight.
But we begin with Fox 17's Jess McMaster in South Haven, one of the hardest hit areas by snow today. And Jess, this is just the beginning because the lake effect snow is starting to crank up.
It absolutely is. And now the plow trucks are salted up and ready to hit the streets of South Haven, but they haven't been out for about 7 hours now and won't be heading back out until about 2 a.m. Now, we've been on the streets of Van Buren County all day and the state trucks are out, but those do not cover South Haven because the city has their own plow trucks. Now, we're told that every street was cleared by noon, but as you can see, the snow is accumulating rather quickly out there. Public Works Operations Manager Ron Dotson says they do get some phone calls, people wondering where those trucks are, and that he has two good reasons why they take a break.
We work them so many hours and you know, they give us all they got, and eventually they got to get some rest in short notice so they can come back in and be able to get home safe. You know, we clean the roads, the salt don't work real good right now as cold as it is. So when you put the salt down, it makes a slush. And by the time you make your rounds and you get back to where you started from, then you got a soupy mess.
Now, Dotson says he's worked with the city of South Haven for 34 years, and this is the worst winter yet. Now, as for Van Buren County, the sheriff's department there tells us they've had 25 calls regarding weather-related crashes and slide-offs. So now is the time to have those emergency kits that we talked about earlier in your vehicle in case you do become stranded. For now, reporting live from South Haven, Jessica McMaster, Fox 17 News.